Hi there everyone, this is Jacob of Jacob LE Video Production. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to set up an autoresponder sequence in Mailchimp in 2019. And then I'll also show you how to set it up so when you do new emails out to your subscribers, you're not emailing people who are currently going through that autoresponder sequence. So what is an autoresponder sequence? Basically, when someone signs up for your newsletter slash email list, it is a series of emails that they would receive generally over a week or 2 weeks. And the reason you might want to do this, it's a really good opportunity to really tell your brand story and provide a lot of value and create basically an automated journey that they go through once they sign up for your email list. And that way they're not kind of randomly thrown into a newsletter update that you do. They're able to go through this journey. So you do want to be providing useful blogs or videos, things that can actually help them, but you also want to tell a story potentially of a customer who has worked with you or bought your product and the impact it's had on them. Like for me, I do video production work, so it's telling the story of people who have gotten amazing results getting clients and customers using the content I've created, which is free, as well as people who have gotten even better results who've worked with me one-on-one directly. So I am capturing my screen and it is pretty easy. I'm under campaigns. You'll go to create. You'll want to choose an email. And instead of regular, we'll want to go to automated. And you'll want to choose welcome new subscribers. If you can also just have one message welcoming people to the page, but for here, instead of welcome message, we're going to choose onboarding series. And we can leave the title as is, or we can call it something more specific. I think onboarding series is fine. I've got my one list. You may have several if you have several different lists. So these are set up to trigger. This one goes out to people immediately after they join the list. And then with this campaign, it has them going out one day after the previous one. So there is the initial email and then four additional emails that'll go out over the following 4 days. And you can change this. You can set it so it's, 2 days. You could do a week. That's probably a little long, but you could do 3 days and space it out. But I'm gonna leave this as 1 day. So I am able to delete an email if I decide that I only want 3 to go out. Also, you can add an additional email. So what you do is go through and design each one of these emails, set them up, do preview, and basically, set them up each individually. And I'm not going to use your valuable time going through creating an email for every single one of these, but that is how you set those up. And we could just do a quick example. I'll just say test. And I'll have to choose next. And can choose a theme. I have found that emails that feel a lot more personal, like you're emailing a friend, have done a little bit better. So it's up to you if you want to include, crazy images and things like that. But, as a small business, it's nice to have something that's a little bit personal. So I'll see if it lets me do it without. So yeah, I have to resolve the issues below, but that's basically because I haven't actually entered in any information here. So let's say we have that set up fully. what you can do in the future so your emails aren't going out to people who are going through this autoresponder sequence is when I go to create, I'll do an email. This one will just be a regular one. I'll do January. I'll click begin. And for sending to, I could do my list, but rather than all subscribers on the list, I'm going to do a group. And I'm going to choose automation activity. So here would be the sequence that you set up. So if I do completed the workflow, that means no one's going to receive the email until they finish the autoresponder sequence that I've set up. So they won't be getting your regular newsletters. They're not going to get two emails in the exact same day, one, you know, being your January message and the other being part of that sequence you walk them through. And you know, a lot of people, they're nervous to email too much. If you have just the right client and your info is helpful, you don't have to worry too much. You can potentially send them once a day if it's good enough. But if you're nervous about, you know, let's say that someone's completed your autoresponder sequence yesterday, you know, they would receive this email if you send it out now because they've completed the workflow. If you wanted to set it up so it's going to be people who have completed the autoresponder sequence and then a week past that, instead of automation activity, you can do the date added to the list and set it up to be a specific date. So, you know, it's the 31st. If your autoresponder sequence takes a week, that means people who started it here have finished. So you could choose, let's say, the 17th, which means you're only emailing to people who have signed up for your list, completed the full sequence, and a week has gone by. So please let me know if this has been helpful. Do not forget to subscribe. Hit the bell to be notified when I come out with new content. I come out with videos at least 3 days a week. For 100 days, I'm doing 100 videos. So I thank you for your time, and I'll see you in the next video.